And we are back for the second hour of session 45 of A Song of Tara. And we have a bunch of happy, happy werewolves. Well, maybe not so happy, but a bunch of werewolves, at least, in a car going from Cork to Belfast. And with various stops for, you know, potty breaks, and Madi needs to be let out so he can wee once in a while, because, you know, dog. And you probably also need something to eat along the way, and so on and so forth. But you do eventually get to the border between Ulster and the Republic of Ireland.
And then it's time to decide if we want to go big family with two dogs or into the Umbra.
Well, we can't really bring the car in the Umbra, can we?
Oh, no. I just meant the two of us.
Oh, the two of us. I can also hide in the trunk using drugs and little CGI and hope that they do not find me.
Might be easiest to just pretend to be a dog.
Well, that might risk quarantines. I don't know what the rules are regarding.
No, you can bring pets across like that.
Okay,
we'll just be two very big and wolfy dogs.
Yes. Yep.
Okay, cool. Well, onward we go.
Yep.
Mike will attempt his best to look cute and dog-like with his tongue lolling out the side of his mouth.
Yes. Please go on. Chris, please go on.
Oh, sorry, I was going to say, wouldn't 4 hours of continuous tongue lolling wouldn't Marty's tongue be rather uncomfortable by now?
It's gone dry!
It's gone!
I mean, that's how he sweats.
It's gone numb.
I suppose. Okay. No, sorry, carry on.
Yes.
He just needs to continuously lubricate it with saliva.
So.
Or water.
Yes. You are.
And all the water leads to him having to go to potty breaks quite a lot.
Yes.
Because dog.
You are let across the border with no problem at all. Cool. The guard at the crossing just, you know, takes a look at people's credentials and goes, well, welcome to Northern Ireland, and there you go.
Thank you.
And it is a popular spot for people to go for, you know, a long weekend or something from Ireland. It's quite normal. So, yeah. You get through with, well, no issue whatsoever. And what then?
Well, the question then becomes, where were we supposed to meet our contact? Was that on this side of the border?
Yes, you were supposed to meet this man, Michael O'Hara, but that was up much closer to the Giant's Causeway, which is basically on the north coast of Ulster, because that's where the Sept is located.
Okay.
So you will pass by Belfast before you get there.
Okay, then we might as well go to Belfast first and see what we can find there.
Indeed.
On their way to Belfast, Taryn is looking at a map and then goes, why the fuck have they called it Londonderry? Cookstown, I am so in on that.
That's a good question, Taryn. I don't know.
It should be said, out of character, Londonderry is usually just called Derry.
Yeah, but she doesn't know that.
No, that's true.
And it does say Londonderry.
Yes. It does. Well, you go to Belfast and head to Shauna's home.
Hey, guys?
Yes?
Do you think we can find milk from Derry, so it will be Londonderry?
We need to check that out. We're gonna be up here for a couple of months anyway.
Yes, but first things first.
Yes, Tally takes a moment to very dryly say, can I just say this is the first time since we started this trip I'm looking forward to being dead.
Come on, it's still island.
Go on.
My opinion remains the same.
Yes.
I think Mardi leans in to Taryn and says, I don't understand.
Understand what?
The London Derry 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 Derry.
He never understands my puns!
Well, basically dairy is milk and cheese and other stuff from cows, you know.
Yes.
So it's called dairy.
Yes.
And London Dairy sounds kinda like it.
Yes.
It's a pun.
He looks thoughtful and then goes, oh. And looks at Edfina with reverence. Do another.
Gotta love that character.
Liam, please pull over.
Liam pulls over.
Tally gets out of the car. I'm walking the rest of the way.
Okay, we'll see you there. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Fenner looks at Deadeye and replies, if it just did them on demand, it would cheapen it.
Okay. Tell me when you do next one.
Oh, God.
You have just driven off without Tally. At what point would you be prepared to stop and let him catch up, if at all? Oh,
100 yards or so.
Okay, thank you. he does you the courtesy of at least sprinting to the car. He doesn't walk the whole way.
Hey, let's go to Hollywood. It comes from her while she's still looking at the...
Well, no, map. Let's go to my sister's place.
Yes, please.
Yes. And you get there. How'd you get there?
What? No death?
Not yet. Later.
Well, yep. Park the car and go to her apartment.
Yes, and...
Go out and go hunt for the sister.
Yep. Marty, can you sense anything out of the ordinary?
Where?
Here.
I try.
Thank you.
And for a second there, I thought it had rolled exactly the same, but it's just almost.
Almost the same.
Almost the same.
So it's up to the storyteller to tell me if I can sense anything.
There is nothing here to be sensed, apart from, well, again, normal background tape, but there's nothing here.
Fenna's going back into Lupus and sniffing around for interesting stuff.
Yes.
Madu shakes his head and mimics Fenna.
Okay.
Well, remember my difficulties... follow it and whatever you would set the difficulty for.
Yep, you sniff around and get in an interesting mixture of ordinary daily smells.
Okay, here's the plan. If there are any police up in the apartment, it might not be a good idea for all of us to go up there. I'll go up there, see what I can find, if anything. I'll try to grab something that you might be able to catch her scent with. Would that work?
Or a picture.
Both? Yeah, both.
I can jump to the Umbra and see if the spirits have noticed anything weird.
Please do. Please
you don't have picture phone?
No, not of my sister.
Also, his phone kinda died. Yeah. It's a new one.
Yeah, it did.
One is not alive.
Tara looks offended at him.
Body is busy sniffing.
Yes.
Tara makes a and go find some shiny surface.
Yes. You walk inside then?
Yes.
Yes. You walk inside and upstairs to her flat, which is on the third floor of this building, and you get there, and there's no police tape or anything of the sort. Which usually only happens if there's been a violent crime anyway, it should be said, so, you know.
Yes, but Liam actually knocks on the door.
Yes.
Oh, he did that once before, barging in.
Yes, he knocks on the door, and after a moment, the door is in fact opened by a man. Looks to be mid to late 20s. Hello?
Police, I assume?
No. No, I live here.
Oh, you cut off the last
button. Oh, sorry, can you hear me?
Yep.
Okay. He says, No, I live here.
Okay. So, my name's Liam.
Oh, right! Oh, right. Shit. Okay, wow. Okay, you fit the description. Are you sure you want to be here? I mean, I've never actually met you, but...
To be quite honest, I'm not sure what the hell to think right now.
Right, I'm just asking, he says, because, you know, I have no beef with you, I've never met you before... And you know, stuff like that. But
right.
Shauna is, well, she's in there, and, you know, if she sees you...
might as well get it over with. Can I come in, please?
Sure. He steps aside. And says, I'm just gonna stay out here and have a cigarette or something, you know, because
seek yeah. cover.
As
oh, and he extends a hand and says, oh, by the way, I'm Seamus.
Hi, Seamus. I'm Liam, but you already know that.
Yes.
It was nice to meet you.
Yes, likewise. And you head inside?
Yep, I think as he walks inside, Liam texts the others quickly saying, no, he doesn't actually.
No, okay. So you head inside, and you can hear noises from the kitchen. And as you approach, you can hear Shauna's voice quite clearly saying, Seamus, who was that?
Sis, do you currently hold a knife?
Get the fuck out of my house! Piss off! Out! Out! I will not have you in my home!
Can I just stand outside the door then and speak to you?
I don't care who you speak to! Whatever! Just get out!
Okay, I'll just stand outside the door and ask you a few questions, okay?
Whatever. She heads back into the kitchen.
as he walks past, what was his name? Seamus.
Seamus.
Well, that went better than expected.
Seamus gives you this. I'm hesitant to say pitying look, but yes.
Can we assume, just for the sake of comedy, that we could hear Shauna shouting from outside? I mean, it sounds pretty...
No, I mean, it's up on the...
two of us and Lucas, maybe?
It's, yes, I would say you can hear something. It is up on the third floor. And, yeah, but it's... You can certainly hear something. It doesn't sound terribly friendly.
Fenner okay. just looks at Marty. They sound energized.
Should we go check?
Not sure. We're rolling for curiosity.
Oh dear, yes, yes, roll for curiosity, please.
I think I said it to 7.
Yes, that's fair enough.
Fail it, fail it, fail it.
Nope.
Damn it.
Nope. You manage to control the urge.
Okay, so Liam steps outside the door. And mm-hmm. So, okay, I'm standing outside the door now. I'm not in your apartment. I'm just going to answer you a few questions and then I'll be out of here. Okay?
No answer.
Did you or did you not call me 9-10-ish hours ago?
She looks around the corner of the kitchen towards you outside and goes, "Are you on the bottle or something?
Oh, I'm
why
not
the
on the
fuck
bottle.
Would I call you? I don't even want you in my life."
No, I suppose you don't. Okay. Has anything happened that you would consider out of the ordinary?
Yes, you showed up!
Apart from that.
No. Does this have something to do with your hairy friends?
In a way, yes.
Or Seamus. He's gonna think he's hanging out with bears.
Just keep that gang away from me.
I'll do my very best.
Bloody hell.
Okay. Good. Okay, so you're okay. Nothing's
yes.
happened to you, and I have a rather awkward phone call to make to our parents now.
Oh, come on! What did you tell them?
I only told them what the, never mind. Okay, I'm going to leave now.
Yes.
And I'll stay out of your life.
Thank you.
I just want you to know one thing.
What's that?
You're going to be an aunt soon.
Well, I pity the child, but good for you.
Yes. Anyway. It was nice to meet you, Seamus.
Absolutely. She's got a temper on her.
Yep.
She's the love of my life, but I don't, you know, I refuse to take her side in this. I want you to know that.
For what it's worth, she has every right to be as upset as she is.
Well, that in itself says something about you, he says. It was nice to meet you.
Mm-hmm. And then Liam Liam leaves the place.
Yes. All right. Probably quite confused.
Actually, I think for the first time there's clarity to all this.
Oh.
He walks out to join the others.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe
what is the difficulty around here? Because she went directly to the Umbra the minute he went up.
Right, we will deal with that now. Now that that is... the difficulty here is 6. Wow, nice. You have... Yes, you are in fact in. No problem whatsoever. And you are surrounded by the same kind of tenement buildings that you know, looks exactly like it did in out of the Umbra, but it's a little tilted and a little crooked and a little more run down and all these things, just like you're used to.
Oh. Alright. Well, she's sniffing around asking the spirits if they've seen anything weird.
You come across a rat darting across the road. It stops and looks at you.
Oh, hello.
Squeak. Squeak, squeak. It actually says squeak. It doesn't say, you know, a rat sound. It says squeak.
Why are you saying squeak?
Squeak, squeak, cheese, squeak. It begins backing away from you very slowly.
Oh, no, 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 no. I just wanted to know if there's anything weird happening around here.
Well, you? I haven't seen you before, says. Also squeak.
This thing, this rat is so very much Gaspode.
Yes. Bark, 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 wolf, bark.
He looks at it with a very fond smile. You remind me of someone I know.
I am glad that you caught the reference, Chris, considering that it has been 2 years today.
Still too soon, isn't it?
It's still too soon, but there needed to be a little homage to Terry Pratchett today, of all days. Alright. Here, the rat looks...
Other than me walking around in here, there's nothing weird going on in these houses, are there?
Define weird. Humans mating is strange.
It's very strange, I'm aware, but, like, have banes been coming by when they usually don't? Stuff like that.
Occasionally, but no more than usual.
All right.
Sometimes one of you guys chase them away.
She looks like she remembered something, taking something out of her pocket and hands it a treat of something she had in one of her snacks. Here you go.
Ooh! Yay!
And thanks for the help.
You're nice. I like you. Thank you. Takes the treats and belts off with it.
And then she just walks around. She's never seen Belfast version of the Umbra.
Nope. Yes, you...
She doesn't know how long it'll take to get belted at by his sister anyway.
Yes. It takes about 2 or 3 minutes. And then you have 20 rats sitting there looking at you.
Oh, no.
Aww. Well, she's just happy too.
they all turn up, sit down on their back legs or hind legs, look up at you with this expectant expression on their faces, like feed us.
Oh my god, they're cute. Well, she starts talking with them.
Yes, well, they are quite talkative. They're also clearly very hungry, and you know, yes, because, you know, definitely.
See, there's a lot of you.
Yeah.
Are there any places around here that has very good food that you have a hard time getting to?
The fruit.
Yeah, there are a couple of places up in the up in that building. One of them says and gestures with its head towards the tenement building behind you.
Well, let's go find you some food, shall we?
Yeah.
And then she makes the climb in the Umbra.
Yes, she makes the climb to
the
a flat
escape.
To a flat on the third floor.
Oh.
She doesn't know that's where she lives. Okay, she. Goes in, and then where is it?
It begins that basically you have a small tail of rats following you, and they begin, you know, once you've let them into the flat, they begin going through cupboards and drawers, and a couple of them start jumping up and down on the fridge.
What have you unleashed, Aaron?
Taryn just grins, still completely unaware of who actually lives.
Yeah, yeah.
With her best impression of snickering sneaker as she leaves and goes, I gotta have a big...
Hey, can you open this? Can you open this?
Hmm?
The fridge.
She looks. She opens the fridge.
Yay!
And then she, you know, stops it so it can't close again so they
yes.
don't
get
accidentally get slapped inside.
Yes, and you...
Now, She points at it. Now, don't move this, because then it can close and you'll never get out again.
Right. Okay.
And then she leaves.
They begin plundering the fridge for food. And she leaves. Okay.
With the best impression of the snickering she's heard, the famed Ragabash back in the
yes.
ISIP do.
Yes. And yes, you get back down to street level, and that's roughly at the same time as Liam gets back down there. Of course,
Liam looks incredibly tired.
I'm going to make an educated guess and say that everything up there is fine.
Well. There is a fire-breathing dragon up there, but other than that, yes.
Wow, that was nice. Okay,
Finna looks up at Liam. She's still on Lupus, so she says in Garu speak. Your sister is very good love.
Right, yeah. Try standing a few feet away from her when she belches forth the fire and brimstone.
I thought dragon was like dinosaur. Your sister is dinosaur?
It's a big figure of speech.
There's no dragon up there. There are no dinosaurs either, at least on this side of the Umbra.
It's a long time since I see dinosaur.
Yeah. Oh, those were fun, simple times, weren't they?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so here's the thing. Our enemy is yanking our chain. Basically teasing us, testing us, taunting us, trying to get us to act, I think. And I think that if you get any texts or phone calls or whatever telling you that, well, something similar to what's basically happened to me. That a loved one is dead or dying or otherwise in peril. My suggestion would be don't rush off to investigate. Like we just did twice. Oh, Taryn, that's not funny.
Taryn is still in the Umbra. That was actually, I think, that was actually Aya snickering.
Yeah, it might have been.
It was me snickering because we just drove 10 hours.
Yeah. Well, at least we got a fun road trip out of it. Didn't we, Marty?
Yes.
Yes.
Although, music could be better.
Yeah. Go ahead, Chris.
I'm sorry. I keep starting. I should just be quiet and let people speak. It's a case of it could also be a heck of a lot worse.
Ooh, like what?
Well,
it could be all One Direction, for instance. Mm. That would be bad.
Mm. Marty looks really confused now because he didn't know that music had a direction to go in.
And seeing this expression and knowing exactly what's... Tally can see how the cogs in Marty's head are turning and why they're turning. He says, it's a band. It's a group of humans who get together and make music together. It's called a band, and they give themselves names that people can remember. And there's a band, a group of these humans called One Direction.
Did I imagine puppies howling together and calling it music?
I see. I know what band is.
And Finna knows full well that she's over-exaggerated it.
Well, I apologize. I apologize for making an assumption then, Marty.
We could make them, yes?
Well, we have a few months ahead of us with nothing to do, so yeah, why don't we make a band?
Let's focus on getting to our final... to our final destination.
Yes. I do have, before we go, I do have one last incredibly awkward phone call to make.
You, at that point, I should say, right around then, you can hear an angry explosion from the third floor all the way down to where you're standing.
When you say an angry explosion, is it an outburst of outrage? Yes. Genuine?
No, no, no. An outburst of anger.
You can see the fire exploding out of the windows.
Yep. Dragon.
Phone call later. Car, now.
Flee! Yeah. Run away! Run away!
Where's Taryn? What has she done?
Breaks her rug and ran away.
Yes!
Why do you just think it's her?
Because you're not there, and I know you're curious, and Liam isn't in the building anymore. So what could it be? And your friends with Snickering Sneaker? It's not difficult to...
No, she's not only friends with Snickering Sneaker. Snickering Sneaker were her mentor for the very first long time.
So you're actually improving my case for the matter for me, thank you.
But she was just going to figure out if something weird had happened in the Umbra.
Well, you see... Well, Liam recognizes her, obviously, as his sister. The rest of you see a dark-haired woman coming out on the balustrade, leading all the flats. Then are side by side, obviously. Then there's a walkway, and you get on a staircase to go downstairs. She's now on the walkway. She's leaning over it, and she's shouting down towards you, going, "This is your fault! I just shopped today! Everything in the fridge is spoiled! Everything! It has got to be you! Just piss off and go away!"
Yes, it's my fault. It's my fault. I went into your fucking fridge and spoiled your food, you dragon!
I think at this point Taryn comes out from around the corner, and then she hears that above her head, and then you can just see her stop at this shout, and then she slowly looks up at the lady, and then she realizes he's yelling dragon back at her, and then you can just see her slowly look down again with a "what the fuck was that about" look.
Oh, Taryn.
He goes, "Oh, what the fuck was that about?"
It's sister.
Oh, there you are, Taryn. Like yep, Taryn, sister. Apparently, I've spoiled
her food. I'm so happy. Apparently, I am so happy I'm an only child. Well, not by choice, but yeah, you know.
Did you know, Taryn, that I have the power to, with my mind, to spoil food?
Wait, is that the third floor?
Yes, it is.
Oh fuck! She still stopped walking.
It wasn't me, it was her, he says, pointing at Taryn.
And she just goes, "Sorry!"
While this is happening, Taliesin has made his way to the car and quietly assumed the shotgun seat. he reaches into his jacket and pulls out a book and is just reading, waiting for the drama to finish.
Well, I think he hears a scratch on the window.
A big boy looks up at Taryn and asks, "What did you do?"
"I might have possibly..." She looks up. "Let in an entire storm of rats into her flat."
Wow.
"But they were hungry."
Marty scratches the window to the front seat.
Aww.
Don't scratch the glass, Marty. And then he opens the door and pats his lap.
You're gonna regret that.
Marty clearly takes the clue and jumps into the car to sit on top of Taliesin, his face very close as he says, "I know final destination. It's movie."
So that's gotta be like 50-kilo wolf.
Yep.
Sitting in his lap for the next
yep.
who knows how many hours.
Yep.
Referencing horror movies.
We're not actually going all the way back because we have our final destination closer this time.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Well, either way.
Terry just sits in on the back seat with a whoops in the face.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're not staying there. You're not staying on my lap all trip, Nardi, but enjoy it while you can.
It's good lap.
Oh, yeah, I'm glad. Yeah, your ass is really comfortable.
Thank you.
You do understand sarcasm, don't you?
He looks at you and doesn't reply.
I don't think he does, Tally.
Well,
but
and
the
both
other
of you,
your family is fine.
Oh, I hope that both of you will enjoy the ride. And that was upon Maddie.
Oh, tell.
He looks very expectantly at Fenna.
We are going for a car ride?
Yes.
But it's also a ride when someone sits on the other when meeting.
Oh.
He looks at Atelier, isn't very excitedly like, did you get that as well?
Tally looks back at Fenna with an expression that is emphatically wooden.
She gives him a literally wolfy grin because she's doing the
list. It's basically he is basically sending her an oaken glare.
Mm-hmm.
That wooden.
While the ones are flying beside us, Terry just leans over. Well, at least your family's all right.
Yes.
She seemed healthy.
Yes, she did. Anyway, let's see if we can find this Mike O'Hara.
Maybe I should get the rats out of the flat again.
They're still there?
Maybe.
No, you know what? Leave them. And let's go.
Yeah, Liam?
Yep.
Before we go off, let go of the wheel and just breathe. Okay? This has been a stressful day for you, and I want you to calm down before we. I want you to burst a blood vessel.
I think that's too late.
Not helping, Taryn.
Okay. I'm okay. Okay. I'm good. Yep. Let's go.
And off we go.
Yep.
A very quiet moment as we wander.
Okay, there we go. Can you hear me now?
Yep.
Sorry, I'd managed to turn off my microphone by accident.
Oh, that happens.
Yes. You are driving up to County Antrim then, which is where the Dolphin's Hope is supposed to be located? Okay.
We had somewhere we had to go first. We got an address for it too.
Yes, that's his address. That's okay. Michael's, yeah. On the way there,
Taryn softly says, I should have kept one of the rats. They were so cute. That's about it.
Well, okay, so you head up there and get to the address in question, but it's fairly late when you get there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we might as well go knock on the door.
Yep.
Or does anyone have any objections?
Sorry, just looks at the house with a... Oh, well. Well, let's go.
Okay.
Everyone has to die someday.
That is true.
And hey, we get to die twice.
That is also true.
You only die twice?
You only die twice.
Depending if we need to do this once more, but I don't think it'll work a second time.
No, it won't. Hell, they might not believe the stories when we actually do die. Do die. Do die.
Do da, do da.
Everybody sing the song.
Oh, the do da.
Oh, do da.
And then she knocks on the door.
Yes. While this is happening, Natalie says, at the risk of pissing on everyone's lollipops, could we perhaps treat the fact that this we're going to be spending the next 4 months essentially in complete radio silence and living an entirely different life with a bit more gravity?
Yes.
Finna is suddenly very protective of his necks.
Why?
Because he said at the risk of pissing on everyone's lollipops.
Taryn looks over at him, and then it seems like it dawns on her. So no more internet?
Nope, not unless you want them to spot you. You have to create unless you are able to create an entirely new identity and make it clear that it's not you.
Alright, it's too big a risk because we can't assume that our enemy doesn't have expert hackers on his side.
I mean, Janet is a glasswalker. There's no saying he doesn't have glasswalkers.
Nope.
So, yes.
It's okay. More time to run.
She just stares at him. I don't think you get the severity here.
Okay, so, just so we're all on the same page here, as soon as we knock on that door, it's, as Tally said, it's absolute and complete radio silence. No electronic communication at all.
And no spirits.
Nope.
It should be said that the address you when you arrive is it is a mansion.
Oh.
All right.
Cool.
It's an old fashioned estate. Basically.
Mm.
Kinda like the house Aaron have.
Slightly larger, but yes.
Cool. But still, we need to be clear on this.
Well,
for all intents and
purposes.
Yep, as do we all. But for all intents and purposes, when we knock on that door, we are dead to the world.
I guess we don't go spirit world, because spirit can tell.
Yes.
Tully actually makes a process of taking out his own phone and, for lack of a better term, dismantling it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
Liam does the same.
Yep.
Maddie doesn't.
For lack of a telephone, so yeah.
Finna doesn't even have a single electronic thing with her.
Nope.
Sneaky.
Cool.
Oh my god. Yes.
So Taryn is holding her phone kind of like a baby with a no.
No.
Yes, Taryn.
But I built it myself.
You can build another one.
This is really, really traumatic for a glasswalker.
You can just see Taryn's face as she says, would you really dismantle your own baby?
Liam get. Oh, sorry, Chris.
No, I'm not saying anything. Actually, I'm just saying. Yeah.
So Liam then thinks on that a moment and then says, "No, I don't think I would."
And we understand each other. At least in her mind.
Okay.
She's still not dismantling it, though. She's just shutting it off.
Can you at least, I don't know, take out the battery? Yeah.
She takes out the battery.
Yeah, she puts her baby in hibernation.
Yeah.
Liam reaches out for the battery. Could you please?
She stares.
Oh god!
And hard, and then just goes, if this battery dies, your flat will be full of rats. And then she hands over the battery.
Thank you, Tim. Now, should we go meet our new host?
Mm. Suddenly playing dead is no longer as fun.
No, no, it really isn't.
It wasn't fun to begin with, but at least she just figured, well, new people to meet, and then now it just dawned on her.
Yep. Well, yep. Liam starts walking toward the entrance.
Charon follows begrudgingly.
Posh place.
Yeah.
Sure. It's alright.
It's alright.
Posh place owned by a guy named Michael. I'm beginning to... This is becoming more ironic than I think is comfortable.
Yes.
Well, my uncle's named Michael too, and he owns most of the skyscraper in New York.
And there's a Michael Blackwell as well.
That was kind of what I was getting at.
I know, Tally.
And at the mention, I should point out the mention of that man's name.
He who must not be named.
Tally does flex his fist instinctively.
Yeah.
Yes.
As we get to the door, I assume, and we knock on it.
Yes.
Someone knocks on it.
And it takes a little while, but you hear a man's voice from the other side eventually going, yes, yes, I'm coming, I'm coming. And finally...
Did you hear that?
Sorry, what?
Yes, yes, I'm coming, I'm coming.
Right, right.
Yeah, I think Marty glances swiftly to Taryn.
Taryn hears him, and then she looks at Marty with a flood.
What? This fellow opens the door.
Wow, gee, hot.
He doesn't wear a jacket, but he does wear the waistcoat.
Aww, couldn't you have him be naked?
Nope, I can't.
When he opens the door, he just looks at Marty. Yeah, I wish to.
Good evening,
yes?
Sir.
Good evening. Oh, wait. You, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You must be the ones that Kat called about.
Yes.
Right.
Indeed be us.
Come on in. Come on in.
Finna is still Lucas right now. She has no shame about walking up to him and sniffing.
He reaches down and scratches her behind the ear.
Nose.
Yeah, she's not gonna let him know right now that she isn't actually naturally Lucas.
No, he still scratches her. If you're gonna sniff him, he's gonna scratch you.
I'm not complaining.
Marty decides that he seems like a nice guy.
Yeah.
Taryn, I'm still holding her impotent phone for now. And that just waves.
Yes.
Bye.
Hello? Well, as I said, please come in. He steps aside so you can enter.
Liam enters.
Yes.
Marty enters.
Well, I must admit, I did not get much in ways of warning that, you know, I haven't known for several weeks that you were on your way, obviously, but well, one good turn deserves another, and Kat said that you guys needed to lie low and basically be dead insofar as the rest of the world is concerned for a while, so he says and looks around, Mikasa, Sukasa.
Thank you, we really appreciate it.
It's feel free to tell me to not bother with this, but could I ask what's going on?
It's you certainly can. I think telling you what's going on is the least we can do.
Sure.
as thanks for your hospitality. But maybe we've been driving through most of the day.
And yes, been... come on in, sit down. Go take a seat in the living room. It's that way, two lefts and a right, and then you're there. It's the room with the television in it. I will be there in a moment. I'm just going to get something to drink for everyone. Tea, coffee, water,
Guinness if you have it.
Oh sure, certainly.
Thank you.
Fenner changes to Hamid. Cola?
Yep, I have that.
I think Mari changes to Hamid as well and says, I think tea.
Tea it is.
Second that for me.
Tea as well. And what about you, young lady? He says and looks towards Taryn. Would you like something?
Tea, please.
See, indeed. Well,
my phone back.
Give me my phone.
She was actually about to just look at Liam. My battery back, please. But she figured that wouldn't help anything.
Nope.
And then she tries to find the room with the television in it.
Yeah.
Sending Liam looks. Now and then, kind of like a kick puppy.
Fair.
Yep. Well, you guys head to the living room?
Yep.
Good. It's very nice house. Very, very nice house. This man must have money like Croesus. To live in this kind of style and, dare I say, opulence.
Do we know that this man, according to his blurb, is in fact the guy in charge of the Dolphin's Hope sept?
No, you haven't been told that much yet.
Okay, fair enough. Just want to establish where.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
Role play.
Yes, you know his name. That's pretty much it.
Okay.
What's a
savoir-faire? Savoir-faire is good mannerisms, elegant, laid-back sort of style, you know. Being able to get along with people.
He's charismatic.
It more or less translates into knowing what to do or how to act.
Yeah.
Yes. Savoir, knowing, fair, yeah.
Hello.
To do.
Anyone? Yep.
Hello.
Hello. Oh, okay.
That's one of those moments.
Yep.
Hello.
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 Hi.
Can you hear us?
Now I can.
Okay. Yeah. You dropped out. Apparently.
Oh, your sound did. Lost sound after it means knowing mannerisms and then no sound.
Yeah.
So I guess it's good, well mannered, knowing how to behave.
Yeah, savoir means knowing, or to know, and fair is to do. So, yeah, knowing how to act.
Okay. Oh, I'm surprised I actually put dots in etiquette for her. Interesting.
I think that was based on her upbringing.
Oh, I have a dot!
Oh my god! Fenna knows how to act. I'm surprised. Anyway, we find the den and we sit down and try to find out what's going on.
Yep.
Joan?
Yeah.
Your turn.
Oh, you're there.
We find the den, sit down and wait.
Yep.
Yes.
This is a post-recording message. As some of you may have noticed, there are only two parts to this session. Unfortunately, our storyteller felt ill, and it was decided that we end the recording early so that she could get some much-needed rest. She's fine, and we'll be back with more Song of Tara next Monday. Until then, have an amazing week, and we'll see you soon.